first of all, creating a project. Inside of Planoly, we are able to create a project. And as we create a project, we can select the templates that we're looking for. Here, an EIR, BIM execution planning appointment, RACI documents, and using that as different tabs. First of all, just the person that's creating it obviously is the one that sees that. And then we would fill this in for our project. And all of these templates are continuing to improve based on the teams that we talked about earlier. And we beckon you to join that as well if you see something that you would like to update in some of these templates. Or you can build them from your own. And when you build them yourself, you can then start to internally share and approve them so that you can then bring in other external parties as well. On the scoping side of things, the first thing from an employer's perspective or an appointing party, they're going to be interested in the assets. So they would have a register of assets that they would put the asset information requirements into. And this would be, first of all, this long list of assets that they would want to add information requirements for certain uses here, whether it's planned maintenance, preventative maintenance, etc. And by assigning even down to the information requirements, we're able to track that. And then we would want to tell teams where to find certain information. So on a dashboard, we can simply provide access to all of those different sources of information. We can add the prospective teams to that workflow. So here, the main contractor is going to be Mega Build. They are going to be a prospective team. And that prospective team would then be seeing just the plan and scope, and they would not see any of the other teams. And as they are into the plan for their pre-contract BIM execution plan that has been assigned to them, they can start completing their details. And for example, here, uploading the CV, the resume of the team members, and sharing that with the teams. Once they have shared that, the teams can comment backwards and forwards with the employer, with the appointing party. And it makes that workflow, instead of being very stunted and very difficult to agree on something, we're able to go through and publish content as we are agreeing rather than waiting for whole contracts to be put in place. It really makes that much more bite-sized workflow. And then as we are moving to the appointment phase, removing certain teams and upgrading others to become project teams. So we're transitioning to that appointment so that everyone can be part of that team. To summarize what we have just seen in a workflow, how your teams can internally review those templates to make them your own, how teams can create information requirements, whether you are the appointing party in an exchange with an owner or whether you are the prime in an engagement downstream. You can use this at any point in time to define what your requirements are and invite prospective teams so that they can respond. You can have a collaborative tendering process and then transition to that appointment phase.